All right, I want to switch gears to the Eastern Conference because, boy, that was a game last night, friends. Sixers blowing a 26-point lead at home in Game 5. The Sixers falling apart in the second half particularly. In fact, Joel Embiid and Seth Curry, the only Philly players to make field goals in the second half. This loss stings even more after they relinquished an 18-point lead to the Hawks in Game 4. How unlikely was this comeback? Exactly. This graphic is amazing. According to win probability, I know it's hard to see on this screen the way we have it, but the Sixers had a 99% chance to win entering the fourth quarter with 7 minutes left. It was still 98.6%.
Oh, my gosh.
Then it starts to go in the other direction, falling to 86 with 3 minutes left, 46 with about a minute left, minute and a half, and here we go. I mean, that's just... That chart is incredible,
Oh my gosh.
And this is the Hawks win probability chart. I know I'm mentioning numbers from the Sixers side, but Ramona, how can the Sixers recover from this loss?
Oh, got to take a breath.
Okay.
Got to take a breath. And then you need, and this is, I hate saying this because Doc Rivers is such a great coach, okay? And he's such a great leader. But I've seen his teams have this happen to them a couple of times. And I think some of it is Doc is a great leader. And sometimes the guys on the court look to him for leadership and they don't do it themselves.
Okay.
And when they're out on the court, there's a way that you can settle people down. And it's not just by scoring, okay? Seth, you mentioned this earlier, Seth Curry and Joel were the only people to score in the second half, okay? One, you look at actually what went wrong. They went to the all-bench lineup, and they put Tobias out there because he's been struggling, and they wanted to get him going. Doesn't work.
Nope.
Okay, Ben misses a couple free throws. He's got to come out. 4-14 from the line. That's not going to work.
Nope.
But superstars win NBA championships, and Joel Embiid finished second in the MVP voting this year. He is a great player. He unbelievable first half in this one, but he can do more. He really can. He's averaging 16.9 field goal attempts per game. He can get 20, 24, 25, 26. He can actually do more. He is that dominant, and when you have this happening to you on the court and it's getting away from you, just feed the big guy every time.
In the mortal words of Giant from Mo Better Blues, this is the roughest of the roughest. They have given the Atlanta Hawks confidence.
Yeah.
This is a team that was...
Okay, time out. I don't know if anyone needed to give Trae Young confidence.
No, that's right.
No, I said
that's
the right. Hawks.
I get you.
Collectively,
yep.
They have given them extreme confidence. They're in the lead now.
Yeah.
They're this We Believe team now.
Yeah.
And this city is behind them,
they're
man.
Going it, back it, to
it's
the
crazy
a,
in Atlanta. We got Quavo going to be there tomorrow.
Yeah.
Maybe Andre 3000 shows up with his flute.
Yep.
You know, Killer Mike. Like, it's that's going to be a crazy, crazy situation. And that's what I mean by roughest of the roughest.
Mm-hmm.
You got Friday night in the A?
Yeah, exactly.
Come on, man.
In like, the summer, too.
I remember KG, Kevin Garnett, in 2008. He won't agree with me with this, but the only time I ever saw him rattled by a crowd a little bit was in Atlanta when the Celtics played there. That place, I know people don't give it the respect it deserves, but at this level, it's an intimidating place. So it's the roughest of the roughest for the Sixers going into that house with
you
gotta deal with him there.
Marc, you sound like you want to go.
I mean, you get teleportation.
If I could get on Rachel's private jet, I could get there.
Call me when you find that private jet. I've never seen it. I will say this about Joel Embiid. To your point, he could be, but the Joel Embiid I saw last night, he was having trouble in that second half doing more. And that is, of course, because of the knee injury. And it's a shame because he's been in such great shape all season. So this is not a fitness issue. But you get tired when you are playing on an injured, hobbled leg. It takes so much more energy the entire game. And we are seeing him wear down a little bit at the end of games. So that's a problem. And the Ben Simmons problem is something that they are going to have to figure out how to solve. It is worth remembering there was an inflection point about a third of the way through this season where Daryl Morey could have made a more godfather offer than he clearly did to trade Ben Simmons for James Harden. And I don't know what extra little piece it would have taken from what he actually offered to the Houston Rockets, but I do know that at some point you can push yourself over the top if you put enough in, and Daryl Morey certainly knows that of anyone. And I just think, I'm not saying he should have done it. I'm not. I want to make that clear.
Yeah.
It is just interesting to remember that as we look back, once we see what happens in this series, because you could have had James Harden not on the Nets, but on your team, so that super team in Brooklyn would not have been as super. And maybe Ben Simmons' trade value if, again, if. I'm not looking to trade Ben off of the Sixers, but if that is what the front office decides, if they decide that, his trade value is less.
So I agree with you on the point at large. I don't know that it was an issue of the Godfather offer. I think it was more, would Houston even really talked them seriously. Mm-hmm. Were they a stalking horse? Were they ever really in there?
That's fair.
Or they were just there to, you know, to bid
up. Again, though, I want to make this clear. So to listen to me, Internet. Yep. I am not saying that Philly should trade Ben Simmons. I am saying this is a reality thing that happened in the NBA this year, and it is context for what is going on right now.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.